So first question, when did you become aware of your spiritual calling? Because you have a unique story, to say the least.
Well, I was born in an agnostic family, so I had no spiritual background, no religion. So I had no idea what was a spiritual calling, actually. I started to understand or to listen about spirituality when I was actually 17, when my mom and I started to look for help, trying to understand what was happening to me. So we enter in the spiritual world, trying to find out how to handle my own things. But since I was born, I knew I was different somehow, mainly when I was 12 years old, and things turned out to be much more deep for me, like remembering past lives, the universe, and everything. And when I was 14, my guides from other dimensions started to explain me that I had a mission, that I have to accomplish that mission in certain years. I have to speak to people and do this and do that. So I kind of knew that I had some kind of connection with something, mm-hmm. but I never related it with spirituality. For me, it was like the natural thing that most of the people have. So so actually, I realized that it was something from the spirituality when I was 17, and other people told me.
What was happening to you that your parents had to, like, or your mom had to, like, start looking like, what's happening to my son? Like, what was happening to you? Yeah. You know, exactly.
Well, at first, of course, like many children had these invisible friends, you know, that usually you play with. But suddenly I was learning things from them. Like, they were teaching me about botanics. They were teaching me about stones. They were teaching me about emotions, about history. They were helping me doing my homework. They were telling me stories. And so that was all normal and natural until I was 12 years old. And one of them told me, next week you will start to remember, and we cannot help you with that. You will have to deal with it until you figure out why you're going to start to remember, and we are going to be here to support you, but we cannot explain to you. So I stopped seeing them, and I started to feel different beings that were not like childhood things, but they were more like guides and people that were around and explaining me about my mission and what I had to do. So I started to remember about the last 12,000 years of my history, what I was doing in Africa, then what I was doing in Europe, and different lives, and all mixed. So it was all a mess. And when I was 16, I started to remember myself, who I was in the universe. So I started to remember dimensions, different realities. I thought I was getting crazy. My mom actually thought I was a very creative person. And everyone around me, they thought, oh, he's a very creative person. All the kids wanted to listen to my stories and what I was remembering. And they were sharing to me their feelings, but very, like, afraid of it. And so some teachers, too, they started to ask me questions. But it turned out to be very difficult for me to handle a normal life with all that in my head. So I ended up going to psychologists. And some of them said I was special. Other ones were saying you have schizophrenia. So I ended up believing that I had schizophrenia, but my mom said, no, you don't. You just have a mess in your head and you need order. So we were always looking for someone helping me, trying to organize what I had in my head. We ended up with these people that helped me energetically to organize what was happening within me. And since that moment, I started to understand much better. So that was the path until I was 18, 19 years old, when I kind of knew what it was all about. Yeah.
So it seems like, yeah, you definitely went through a gauntlet within your own mind. So now you remember all your lives for the last 12,000 years. And as I've spoken to spiritual masters around the world, the concept of remembering your past lives can be dangerous, knowing too much about where you came from, because it could affect the current incarnation. So my question to you is, how do you deal with this knowledge, and not only some knowledge, very detailed knowledge of many, if not all, of your past lives for the last 12,000 years, walking around in this reality, in this incarnation, with a library of information from other lifetimes? Like, how do you deal with that psychologically?
Yeah, it was very difficult because I started to remember as a child, not right. as an adult.
Right.
And so for me, it was like very chaotic. So I had no idea what was actually happening, and all the information was mixed. And every time that I had the chance to speak with one of my guides, they said, don't think about it, just write about it and make drawings about it. But don't think about it, because you have nothing to do with it now. It all will make sense in the future. But this is the right moment for you to remember it. So go through the emotion and remember that emotion is the keeper of information. So that's why you have to feel it, not think it. Mm. And so I went through hell because I was feeling every one of my deaths, all the people that died around me, all the different things that I couldn't accomplish, me being the bad guy, me being the good guy, many lives as a woman, confusing me in this life as a man. So it was like so many things, so many confusing things, and then other realities. So... Yeah. Yes. So eventually, one of my guides told me to do a specific meditation that was watching a wall for a long time. And every thought and emotion that was coming to me, I was supposed to leave it in that wall, like concentrated in the tiniest spot that I could ever imagine inside that wall, and put it there until I just see the white wall. And it helped me to clear my mind until everything was empty. Like suddenly from that moment, since that specific moment, I started to have my mind in blank. And whenever someone asked me something, the information was coming through, but I was not thinking about it. So it helped me to basically get rid of all this data and information that weren't actually useful. Because I said, for example, if I had to explain to someone why a pyramid exists, why don't you give me the information of the pyramid instead of having to suffer all this? I don't know, my husband dying in another life, my children or whatever, and feeling the love with my grandmother in that life. Why suffering so much with so many memories? And they said, because you remember the pyramid through the love that you felt of the people that were there, learning with you what the pyramid was. Because nobody remembers things just because of information. You remember things because you feel things. Right. So you need to remember the emotion of those people or those situations you were in order to access the information that you knew in that moment.
To watch the full video, click on the link below. And don't forget to subscribe.